Hi, my name is Ashraf Tiwari and welcome to this tutorial on how to create self-graded online quizzes using Google Docs. By the end of this tutorial, you should be able to create a multiple choice online quiz using Google Docs and a script called Flubaroo. We will also explore the different features that are available through this very useful add-on. Your final product would look something similar to this online algebra quiz that I created for the purpose of this tutorial. As you know, online quizzes can be beneficial for many reasons. For starters, this type of assessment can help teachers identify learning gaps. As we will get to explore later on in this tutorial, Flubaroo can actually provide you with graphing analysis to spot any learning gaps within your group of students. Also, not only these quizzes allow both students and teachers to see progress over time, they can also encourage students to actually study. Okay, so let's get started. Assuming that you already have a Google account, go to google.com and access your Google Drive from the top bar. Once you are on the Google Drive page, click on Create, scroll down to Form, and then select it. The first thing you want to do, of course, is give a title to your quiz. For the purpose of this tutorial, I am going to name mine Algebra Quiz. Up here in the description, you can add in any instructions that you wish your students to follow. Remember, you can always check how the quiz would look like at any time by clicking the View Live Form. Next, you will want to create an information box where students type in their names and emails. Such a task can be achieved very easily by going to question title, type in first name, and the question type, make sure to select text since students will be required to provide a text input. The help text is optional really, unless you have very specific instructions such as enter your first name in my case, which will look similar to this when you're done. Also, don't forget to check the required question box. Next, follow similar steps to create information boxes for last name and email address. So what you need to do is go to the option here in the middle where it says duplicate, click on that, and the entire section you have previously created will duplicate. Update the information in the second section to last name and keep text as a selection. Again, you can click on View Live Form to check your progress at any time. Okay, now we need a section for the email address. So once again, go to the section you have just completed and click on Duplicate. Same process once more. All you need to do is update the new section to email address and keep text as an option in the question type. Also, it's important to note that students must enter their email address because Flubaroo will actually give you the option at the end to email feedback directly to students. So I think it would be nice to have their email address on your response sheet, which I will discuss here in a second. Now it's time to create a multiple choice quiz question. Again, duplicate the last section of your quiz that you created. In the question title, type in the question number and the question text. In the help text, you can put in any instructions you'd like or leave it blank. That's completely up to you. Since this is a multiple choice quiz, I am going to select checkboxes for the purpose of this tutorial. You can also choose multiple choice or choose from the list options if you'd like. Here in option 1, this is where I'm going to list the first answer choice. For this question, for example, I am going to include 4 answer choices. So as you can see, each time I click inside the box, the next box is created for me automatically. Again, you can click Done and check your progress by going to View Live Form. This particular quiz will include 10 questions in total, So we will need to repeat exactly the same steps that we followed when we created the first question. And that, of course, starts with duplicating the first question and updating the question text and the answer choices for each quiz question that follows. So once you're done entering all the questions and the answer choices, now it's time to make your quiz a little more attractive. So this is a fairly simple task. All you need to do is navigate to the top of the page, click on the Change Theme option, and then you will be given a list of theme options to choose from. Select the one that you like and then view it online to see if you're satisfied with it. Now, since this is going to be a self-graded quiz, what we need to do first is take the quiz ourselves so that we can input the correct answers. Notice here how I entered the words answer key in the name boxes so that I can easily spot the answer input on my response sheet, which I will discuss here in a second. As soon as you submit the correct answers, Google Docs automatically creates a submission sheet for you. On the response sheet, you can see the date, the time of submission, and the answers that were submitted as well. But before we can use Flubaroo, we will need at least 2 submissions from students so that it can do the grading for us. Notice each time a student makes a submission, your response sheet gets updated instantly. Next, as soon as you have enough quiz submissions from students and you are ready to grade this assignment, go ahead and install the Flubaroo add-on. This is fairly easy, so all you need to do is go to Add-ons and make sure you are on the response sheet. Then scroll down to Get Add-ons. As soon as, as you can see, I already have Flubaroo installed, but I will walk you through the process again. In the Add-ons search box, go ahead and type in Flubaroo and hit Enter. Click on the Add option and follow the simple steps. Now that you have the Flubaroo add-on installed, go to Add-on, choose Flubaroo, and then Grade Assignment. For step 1, you have the option to assign and customize the number of points you will want to assign for each question. In step 2, you will be asked to choose the submission to be used as the answer key. Here we made it easy from the start since I named my own submission the answer key earlier, so we are gonna go ahead and select that. And finally, Flubaroo will grade the student submissions for you against the answer key you submitted at the beginning, and you will receive a report that should look similar to this one. In this report, Flubaroo can provide you with a summary section where you will see the average points scored. In this example, everything is based on 5 student submissions. The number of submissions is, of course, very helpful. If, for example, you have 30 students in class and only 15 submissions, you would automatically know that half the class did not take the quiz. And also you have the number of low scoring questions, and this shows you where students have struggled the most. In this case, questions 7 and 10 are where students scored low on average, and it is highlighted in bright orange. Finally, notice how student number 3 is highlighted in red. This means that this particular student did not achieve 70% or higher. So Flubaroo obviously directs my attention to this student or any other student who might score 60% or lower. In addition, Flubaroo will provide you with grading report or graphing analysis to get a better understanding of student overall performance. In my case, as you can see, 1 student scored 30%, 2 students scored 70%, One student scored 80% and one student scored a 90% on this algebra quiz. So you can imagine how useful this tool can be if you have a very large number of students in your class. At the end, Flubaroo gives you the option to email scores to each student individually. What I like the most about this method is the fact that students receive feedback directly from their instructor, and therefore this can improve the student-instructor interaction. In this example, the instructor can include a list of questions and scores as well as the answer key to allow students to review their work. Not to mention that Flubaroo can give you the option to include a message to the student if further feedback is needed. Well, that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you are now familiar with how to create online self-graded quizzes using Google Docs and Flubaroo. Thank you for watching.